Robert Mnangagwa, kicking off a chain of events leading up until today. And here are some facts about Emmerson Mnangagwa that you may not have known.
Now, President Robert Mnangagwa has many notable statements in his terms of office, but here are some that are interesting under the current circumstances.
Is a President Robert Mnangagwa quote, "I will be there until God says come, but as long as I'm alive, I will head the country forwards, always backwards, and never," something that he said in the past, and I guess that is being tested at the moment.
And he says as well, "I have died many times. That's where I have beaten Christ. Christ died once and resurrected once." So this, of course, speaks to the many times that Robert Mnangagwa travels to Singapore to receive medical treatment. And there's always this speculation that he's dead. Mm. And the rumors go berserk. And then, of course, he arrives at the airport and he's fine.
It may also speak to his sense of self, yeah. We could say. All right, let's take you back to some of the facts about Emmerson Mnangagwa. He was born in, you can say that word,
Zishavani.
In Zimbabwe, and he's from the Karanga subgroup of the majority Shona community.
Yes, he's nicknamed the Crocodile Ongwenya. And he's seen as a key link between the army, intelligence agencies and ZANU-PF party. He was, of course, the first security minister back in the day, early 1980s.
He received training in Tanzania, China and Egypt, tortured by Rhodesian forces after his troops staged attacks.
So that's definitely a battle-hardened individual. He had a large influence in directing Zimbabwe's 1970s War of Independence.
In the 80s, he was the country's spy master. According to a UN report, he was seen as the architect of the commercial activities of ZANU-PF, some saying that he does have a strong sense of business. In 2014, Mnangagwa appointed Mnangagwa as vice president. In 2012, a local news reported that he had been poisoned at a ZANU-PF youth rally, and then he came to South Africa for treatment. There was some speculation at the time that he may have been poisoned by a political rival. And you know about the other controversy in the 80s. Mm. He was alleged to have been involved in Matabeleland.
We can't distance him from the Gukurahundi operation that took place in 1983, where what the authorities said, dissidents, and these were former ZIPRA operatives that were on the run. And the president sent in this 5th Brigade into Matabeleland. And this has become the subject of what many people might even have described as genocide, crimes against humanity.
Tens of thousands.
And he's hardly ever spoken about it. There was an interview that happened on SABC with Dali Tambo some time ago, where he sort of gave some thoughts and he said something to the effect that, you know, during war times, difficult things happen. So he didn't really want to speak about it. But that is always going to be something that follows him around. And the Ndebeles have never really forgiven him for that reign of terror that took place at that time.
And he's been so linked to Robert Mnangagwa and his presidency as a minister in various different, what's it called, cabinets?
Yes, he's had a lot of positions. Yeah, and the most recent Minister of Defense and then Vice President.
All right, we take a short break.